Welcome back, Tech Sky enthusiasts. In our last session, we uncovered the vulnerabilities of WEP encryption on busy networks. Today, we're venturing into a scenario where the network is quiet and data traffic is scarce. Join me as we explore the intricate strategy of executing a fake authentication attack to crack the WEP key, even in such conditions. Step 1. Switching to monitor mode. Before we embark on our attack, let's ensure our wireless interface is properly configured. We'll start by examining our interface mode using the command iwconfig. This command provides essential information about our wireless interface, including its mode. In our case, we'll find that our interface is currently set to managed mode, which is not conducive to our attack. To proceed, we need to switch our interface to monitor mode, which allows us to passively listen to all wireless traffic within range. But before we do that, we need to obtain the MAC address of our wireless device, which will be used later in the attack. We can retrieve this information by executing ifconfig wlan0, where wlan0 is the name of our wireless interface. Now armed with our MAC address, we'll initiate the transition to monitor mode. This involves bringing down our wireless interface with ifconfig wlan0 down, ensuring there are no conflicts with other processes using airodump-ng check kill, and finally switching the interface to monitor mode with iwconfig wlan0 mode monitor. Once completed, we'll bring our interface back up with ifconfig wlan0 up. With our interface successfully switched to monitor mode, we're now ready to proceed to the next step. Step 2. Targeting Tech Sky. With our interface configured correctly, let's identify our target, the Tech Sky access point. We'll utilize the airodump-ng tool to list all nearby wireless networks and their associated clients. Running airodump-ng wlan0 provides us with a comprehensive overview of the wireless landscape around us. Once we've identified the Tech Sky network, we'll focus our attention on it by filtering the results using its BSSID, which is the MAC address, and the channel, which is the channel number. This ensures that we're specifically targeting the Tech Sky network for our attack. Now execute command airodump-ng, BSSID, here write the MAC address of your access point, and channel, write the channel number here, then wlan0, which allows us to narrow down our focus to the Tech Sky network operating on channel 6. Upon inspection, we may notice that there are no clients currently connected to the Tech Sky network, and the data traffic is minimal. This presents a challenge for us, as the lack of data packets makes it difficult to crack the WEP using traditional methods, injecting packets for traffic generation. To overcome this obstacle, we need to inject packets into the network to stimulate traffic. By doing so, we can force the access point to generate new packets containing initialization vectors, which are essential for WEP key cracking. However, before we can inject packets, we must first authenticate our device with the access point. Step 3. Executing fake authentication. To initiate the fake authentication attack, we'll start by setting our wireless interface to the appropriate channel using the command airodump-ng start wlan0.6. This ensures that our interface is synchronized with the Tech Sky network's channel, facilitating communication between our device and the access point. Next, we'll execute the fake authentication attack using airplay-ng, fake auth, 0, a, here MAC address of our access point, h, and here is the MAC address of our device, e, which is the name of our access point, wlan0. Let's break down this command. Fake auth 0 specifies the type of attack, fake authentication, and the number of packets to send. In this case, 0 indicates that we want to perform the attack once. A MAC specifies the MAC address of the target access point Tech Sky. H MAC specifies the MAC address of our wireless device, obtained earlier. ESSID specifies the network name of the target network Tech Sky. wlan0 specifies the name of our wireless interface in monitor mode. Upon execution, this command initiates the fake authentication process between our device and the Tech Sky access point. The access point will recognize our device as a legitimate client, despite not being actually connected to the network. This authentication association enables us to inject packets into the access point, bypassing the requirement for an actual connection. Results of fake authentication. Following successful fake authentication, we'll observe a change in the authentication status off field in the airodump-ng output. The absence of a value in the off field prior to the attack indicates that no authentication was established. However, after executing the fake authentication attack, we should see an OPN value in the auth field, indicating a successful authentication association. With this association established, we now have the capability to inject packets into the TechSky network, even though we're not physically connected to it. This opens up opportunities for further exploitation and web key cracking, despite the initially sparse data traffic. By executing a fake authentication attack, we've demonstrated the strategic approach required to crack a WEP key in scenarios with minimal data traffic. In our next video, we'll delve even deeper into packet injection techniques and explore advanced strategies for network exploitation. As we navigate the intricacies of ethical hacking, let this journey be a testament to the fact that security is not merely a destination but an ongoing pursuit. The vulnerabilities unearthed in protocols like WEP serve as valuable lessons, propelling us toward innovation and the development of more resilient defenses. In this evolving digital frontier, knowledge isn't just power, it's the very key that unlocks the doors to a secure future. As we wrap up this exploration into WEP's vulnerabilities, I encourage you to hit the like button, subscribe, and share your thoughts. I'm Brandon, your guide on this fascinating odyssey through ethical hacking. Until our next expedition into the realms of cybersecurity, stay curious and stay secure.